walking across the Oval, you'll most likely hear the chimes sounding from Orton Hall. Although it's hard to imagine a campus without the sound of ringing bells now, there was a time when there were no bells to be heard. Catherine Montalto, an associate professor in the Department of Human Sciences, has researched the history of the Orton Hall bells extensively.
It's one of the two oldest buildings on our Oval, along with Hayes Hall. The construction of Orton Hall was completed in 1893, and the building is beautiful and grand. It is built from all stones that are native in the state of Ohio, and it was built with that beautiful tower. So the building opened in 1893, but there were no bells in the bell tower, and the building actually existed for over 20 years before the bells were placed in the tower.
What people might not know is that students played a large role in purchasing the bells.
It was the graduating class of 1906 that decided they wanted their class gift to be fundraising towards the purchase of a set of chimes that could be placed in the tower. And so they established the chime fund and made a very nice donation to the fund, but not enough to be able to buy the chimes.
The class of 1906 was just the beginning.
It actually took several succeeding classes who also embraced the chimes fund as their senior class gift.
The classes of 1907 to 1911 and 1913 and 1914 also made financial contributions.
And so in 1914, they had amassed sufficient funds to purchase a set of 12 bells to put in the tower. They had amassed $8,000. If you inflation adjust that to 2017, those classes had raised nearly $200,000.
The bells were officially installed just over a century ago in 1915.
Our bells were actually manufactured by the McShane Bell Company that was in Baltimore, Maryland. 12 beautiful bells were delivered to campus on February 11th of 1915, and there are wonderful pictures in the archives of the 12 bells sitting on the ground outside of Orton Hall. A crane was used to lift the bells up to the attic, and then from the attic they were installed into the bell tower, and they're installed in layers with larger bells lower, as you would expect, and the smaller bells as we move up.
Unlike now, during the first 5 years that the bells existed, they had to be played manually by faculty and students in the Chimers Club.
A lot of these students were music students, but if you weren't a music student, they would train you on how to play the chimes, and then when there was a need for concerts or playing of the bells, any of these people who had been trained could go up and play the bells. The graduating class of 1919 and 1920 decided to give another class gift towards the bells so that we could put a clock mechanism in the bell tower.
In the late 1980s, Ohio State installed an automatic system to play the Westminster Peal, rotated the bells, and replaced the claviers with an electric keyboard.
In 2003, we added two more bells to the set, so now we have 14 bells. I mentioned that we call our set of bells chimes, and if you look up words around what it means to have a set of chimes or what it means to have a carillon, in order to qualify as having chimes, you need to have between 8 and 23 bells. So I mentioned we originally installed 12 and now we have 14. So we meet that definition of being a set of chimes. Those of us that are on campus today hear what's called the Westminster chime. So at quarter after the hour, you will hear the first bar of the Westminster peal. At the half hour, you'll get two bars. At quarter till, you get three bars. On the hour, you hear all four bars. Then the lowest, our biggest bell, which is our lowest note, is used to strike the hour. So I think one of the best times to be on the Oval is at noon or at midnight, because the chimes play all four bars of Westminster Peal, and then you get the lowest bell striking 12 times for the hour. But if you ever hear songs being played from the bell tower, like Carmen, Ohio, then you know someone is up there playing the bells.
During my visit to the bell tower, I was able to play Carmen, Ohio. The student organization, Ohio Staters Incorporated, operates the bells for special occasions.
We will play the bells for the commencement eve ceremonies. There are honorary systems at Ohio State that ask for the chimes to be played when they're doing their initiation. And occasionally alumni will ask for the bells to be played when they're doing a proposal or maybe having a wedding reception on campus. I think for all of us on campus, when we walk across the Oval and we hear the chimes in Orton Hall, it conjures lots of memories of time and change and friendships on campus. And it's clearly one of my favorite moments is when I'm on the Oval and the chimes play.
Whether they're playing Carmen, Ohio or the Westminster Chimes, the bells of Orton Tower have now made over a century of students and alumni feel welcome at Ohio State.